Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will discuss about different types of resistors, their functions, characteristics and usages. Let's discuss numerous types of resistors that are used in electronic circuit. These different types of resistors have different properties and used for various applications. Normally, resistors can be classified into two basic types, namely linear resistors and nonlinear resistors. Linear resistors are those resistors in which their current value is directly proportional to the applied voltage. Their VI characteristic curve is a straight line or linear. Nonlinear resistors are those resistors whose current does not change linearly with the changes in applied voltage. The variations in current and voltage values depend upon other factors like temperature and light and does not change according to Ohm's law. There are several types of nonlinear resistors, but most commonly used resistors are, first one, thermistors. Thermal means temperature. The resistance varies with a change in temperature. So, a thermistor can detect the changes in temperature. Thermistors are used for measurement and control purposes. Second one, photoresistor. Photo means light. In this resistor, the resistance varies with the change in intensity of light. It is also called as LDR, light dependent resistor. The photoresistor's resistance decreases with increase in intensity of light. Photoresistors are used in flame detectors, light meters and photographic devices. Next one, varistors. The resistance of a varistor varies with the applied voltage. As the voltage increases, the resistance decreases and vice versa. It is also called as VDR. Voltage-dependent resistor. Varistors are used to eliminate high voltage transients or spikes. Now the linear resistors. There are two basic types of linear resistors, namely fixed resistors and variable resistors. Fixed resistors, as the name says, its resistance value is fixed. Fixed resistors are the most widely used in electronic circuits. Variable resistors. As the name indicates, we can vary the resistance values manually according to the requirements with the help of knob or shaft connected to them. Variable resistors are further divided into potentiometer, rheostats and trimmers. A potentiometer is simply called as a pot. It is a three-terminal device. The resistance between two terminals A and B is constant, while the middle terminal W is connected to moving contact wiper. The value of resistance can be changed by rotating the shaft, which moves the wiper contact. Potentiometers mostly used as a volume controller in TV sets and music systems. Second one, rheostat. Rheostats are also known as tapered resistors or variable wire wound resistors. A resistive wire is wound around an insulating core. A wiper slides over this winding. Terminal A and B are connected at both ends to offer a fixed resistance. Terminal C is made to the wiper or sliding contact. We can obtain desired resistance value by moving slider manually. Rheostats are mostly used in speed control of heavy motors. Third one, trimmers. In short, they are called as trim pot. The value of the resistance can be changed by turning the position of the screw with the help of a small screwdriver. These are small variable resistors used for tuning and calibration. Now, fixed resistors. They are classified into different types depending upon their manufacturing process and the material used. We will discuss them one by one. Carbon composition resistors. These resistors are made up of carbon particles and binder like clay. These type of resistors are very cheap and used in applications in dealing with high voltage power supplies and current limiting circuits. On the other hand, they are less stable, means their temperature coefficient is very high and also makes high noise, so they are less accurate. Next one, wire wound resistors. These are the oldest type of fixed resistors but are being used even now. These resistors are made by wounding a metallic resistive wire around a ceramic core. The thickness of the resistive wire decides the resistance of the wire wound resistor. Generally, tungsten, manganese and nickel used as a resistive wire, whereas backlight or ceramic clay material used as an insulating core. Wire wound resistors are very accurate. They work excellently for low resistance values and high power ratings. There are some disadvantages of wire wound resistors. They are costly, have a very low temperature coefficient and can't be used in high frequency equipment. Wire wound resistors are used in testing and measuring devices. Next type of resistors are film type resistors. The film resistors have a resistive layer on a ceramic base whose thickness defines the type they belong to. The thickness of resistive layer on thick film resistor are much higher than thin film resistor. There are three main types of thick film resistors and two types of thin film resistors. Let's discuss them one by one. First type of thick film resistor is fusible resistor. These resistors are same like wire wound resistors. Fusible resistors performs double jobs, means they act like a fuse along with providing resistance in the circuit. The resistance value of fusible resistor is less than 10 ohms. They are widely used in TV sets and expensive electronic circuits to limit the current. Next one, Cermet film resistors. These resistors are made up of special material called Cermet. Cermet is a combination of ceramic and metal. This combination provides advantages in both these materials. They provide high stability when operated in high temperatures. Another type of thick film resistor is metal oxide film resistors. These type of resistors are formed by oxidizing a thick film of tin chloride on a ceramic substrate. These resistors are available at low cost, can withstand high temperatures, can be used at high voltages, but on the other hand, they have poor temperature coefficient. If we compare them with other resistors, they offer moderate stability and noise. Now the thin film resistors. The first type of thin film resistor is carbon film resistor. So if you observe the internal structure, you will find that on ceramic substrate, the thin layer of the carbon film is deposited in the form of spiral tracks. So, just by varying the pitch of this spiral track, the resistance values can be varied. The main advantages of these resistors are, they're available at low cost, produce low noise, tolerance value is also low, have a wide operating range and high stability. So, these type of resistors are used in high voltage and high temperature applications. The other type of thin film resistor is metal film resistor. These resistors are same in construction like carbon film resistors. But the main difference is, instead of carbon film, a thin layer of metal film, nickel chromium, is deposited in the form of spiral tracks on a ceramic substrate. The main advantages of these resistors are, they are available at low cost, produces low noise and their tolerance and stability are also very good. These resistors have low temperature coefficient, means resistance is less affected by the changes in temperature. So they are preferred for high frequency applications. Apart from all these type of resistors, you might have seen tiny resistors in various PCBs. These resistors are surface mount resistors. These resistors are also called chip resistors, which means a resistive layer integrated on a ceramic chip. The invention of these resistors changed the look of a PCB. These resistors are made by taking a ceramic substrate on which a thin film of resistive layer is deposited. This resistive layer is typically metal oxide or metal film layer, and on top of the resistive layer, the protective insulating layer is deposited. On both sides, there are metallic contacts are attached so that assembly resistor can be soldered on the PCB. The advantages of surface mount resistors are compact in size, high stability, they have a good tolerance, more accurate, and they are effective in reducing heat dissipation. So that's all about different types of resistors. So in the next video, we will discuss about how to find out the resistance value of a resistor with the help of color code or code written on them. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notifications for more such videos. My next video is about resistor color coding. Have a nice day.